while ago, Veritasium uploaded a video about how electricity really works. The basic setup is that we have a light bulb and a battery 1 meter apart, which are connected by a wire that is 1 light second long. It claims that the bulb takes 1/c seconds to turn on, not 1 second as you might think. So basically the electricity does not need to move along the whole cable. I agree with Veritasium, he only made one minor mistake. The result is not 1/c, but 1 meter/c seconds. Unfortunately, the explanation in this video didn't really make sense to me, and other videos on the topic didn't explain it well. So I'll try to give you a better explanation. The setup is basically like two antennas. The energy gets transmitted between them by electrical and magnetical fields. So let's draw an equivalent circuit. We can represent a part of the electrical field with a capacitor and a magnetical field with an inductor. When the battery is connected, a wave of current starts flowing through the wire because of the capacitors. They conduct in the beginning but quickly charge up and no more current flows through them. The current that flows through the inductors also causes a current on the receiving side through induction. This only happens while the current wave is traveling through the inductor. So let's imagine the wave traveling through the first capacitor inductor pair. It causes a small current on the receiving side, but once the wave has passed, the current stops. This is why some people think their setup can only transmit energy when alternating current is used, but that's not necessary. As the wave travels along the wire, it hits the next capacitor inductor pair and the current keeps flowing. The same process repeats all the way to the end of the wire. If we assume that the wire has no resistance, it is easy to plot a graph. In the beginning, we get a small current transmitted by the capacitors and inductors, and as the current wave reaches the bulb, we get the full current. The value of the initial current is determined by some coupling factor. Of course, in the real world, this would be much more complicated. Do you agree with my explanation? Let me know in the comments if you have any questions.